Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق حديث كتاب الله عز وجل وأحسن هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة في الإسلام بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah Azza wa Jal. We praise Him and we extol Him and we seek refuge in Allah Ta'ala from the evil within ourselves and evil results of our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides can be never left astray in misguidance. Whomsoever Allah allows to be left astray, there is no guide for that individual. Rated the most truthful of speech is the Book of Allah Ta'ala, the Quran Majid, and the finest guidance of that is that of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the most evil of affairs are the newly invented matters, bid'ah. Every bid'ah is a going astray, and every going astray leads to the hellfire. O you who believe, ittaqullah, have the consciousness of Allah, and always speak a word that is directed towards the truth. As a result, Allah will rectify our situation, and He will forgive us of our sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has indeed achieved a firm handhold. Amabad, as what follows. Today, my dear Wassalam and Iman, I would like to speak about a very touching subject matter, which is the importance of our Iman and the need for us to understand what are the signs or the alamat, the signals and the triggers of our Iman. And how do we, or how can we determine that our faith is real? Wallahi alhamd. Wallahi tawfiq. And Wallah is our success. Iman, faith, my dear brother salam, in Iman, is like a tree. It's like a tree that needs nurturing. It needs affection. Like that feeling that we have, which we call so loosely as love. Love is a thing which experts have suggested that one of the main ways that we can know or realize that we are in love with a person, place, or thing is that we cannot stop thinking about that. One of the main ways that we realize that we're in love with a person, place, or thing is that we cannot help ourselves but always think about that object. So how can we tell that our love with Allah tabarak ta'ala is true and is consistent? Because al-muhabba, the action of love, is something which should be a consistency. It's not a one thing or it's not a one-way street. It goes both ways. So when we as believers can truly say that we're making an effort in the direction of iman with love and ikhlas, waniyyah, sincerity to Allah ta'ala, according to the sunnah of Messenger wasallam, is when we'll realize the importance of polishing and cleaning our iman. Because many people nowadays are at the crossroads with their iman, with their faith. And many people now are starting to struggle with their iman, with their faith in Allah ta'ala, to the point that many people, I'm speaking specifically about Muslims, are starting to question their faith. And they're even doubting their faith. And many Muslims are now at the point where they're feeling hypocritical in themselves, to the point where they become suicidal. These are real issues that Muslims are dealing with on a daily basis. Many of us are not aware of this, but these are issues that we are struggling with as an ummah on a daily basis. So today, my dear Salam and Iman, I'd like to speak about the importance of polishing our iman until it becomes something of certainty of faith. As Allah calls it in the Quran, yaqeen. So inshallah, when we as believers realize that iman is something which is built and it comes about in stages, it is not one and the same. And it is not something which is laying dormant or stagnant. Iman is something which requires nurturing. It requires love. And my first advice in this cultivation process of our iman is that we as individuals, we have to always be on the lookout to find ways and means in which we can cultivate and bring up our iman on a daily basis. Because as believers, it is not enough for us to just profess and say that we're Muslim. Wallah alhamd. No. But we have to actually take some steps to increase in our iman. For example, Allah Azza wa Jal give us a very excellent example of this in Surah Hujurat, ayat number 14 to 15. Allah Azza wa Jal speaking to those Bedouin Muslims, حول المدينة, where they said, Allah Azza wa Jal says, قال الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قلوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم. صدق الله. The Bedouin Arabs, they say, just as they entered into the fold of Islam, they said, we are believers. Allah putting them in check, saying, don't say that you are believers. Say that you are Muslims. Aslamna. Because the real faith has not yet entered into your hearts as yet. So this is a proof. And ulama of Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah have used this ayah as a clear and concise evidence that iman is a stage and is something which is totally different from Islam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla gives us the description of the believers by saying, "Alladhina amanu billahi wa rasulihi thumma lam yartabu." Those who had believed in Allah and His Messenger, and then they had no doubt in their iman, in their faith. So the first step in our polishing of our iman. The first step for us is to remove the doubt. And the way that we can move the doubt, the one and most practical way for us to remove the doubt from our hearts is for us to be inquisitive as believers. We have to be inquisitive and we have to inquire about the deeds of iman. We have to be inquisitive and ask questions about how to increase in our iman, like a child. Like a child who genuinely does not know. When a child genuinely does not know, the child will ask. The child will always ask questions. We have to be humble. When we want to increase in our faith, we have to be humble and ask questions. And when we ask questions, we cannot come as if we already know. We have to come humbly with our cups already empty. We have to come humbly and approach this faith with a humble approach, with our cups empty. And bi'idhnillah, we will benefit from the question, because then that questioning will transform our character and our hearts into that of faith. And then bi'idhnillah, we have to take the steps to polish our iman. So the first matter that I want us to understand is, for our iman to grow, we have to look at it as a seed that we plant in the ground. We cannot just throw the seed in the ground and hope for it to grow. We have to nurture it. We have to nurture that seed. As the scholars of the Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah, they have mentioned that the iman, our iman, yazid bita, yunqus bil ma'asiyah, that our iman will increase with acts of obedience to Allah tabaraka ta'ala, and it will decrease with acts of disobedience to Allah. So iman, it does not just stay stagnant. It does not stand still. Either our iman is going up or iman is coming down. If we're not constantly looking for ways to increase in our iman or in doing the deeds of our iman, then know for a fact that our iman is decreasing. Faith, my dear salam, iman is something which requires nurturing. Just like a relationship that we have with a person, a place, or a thing, that loving relationship that we have, it requires nurturing. We have to nurture that relationship. And we have to ask questions. If we have a person in our life or we have experienced love, then we have to question that person to find out the reasons why we are in love with one another. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He reminds us of this questioning on the part of His beloved Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Khalil ar-Rahman, the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam asked Allah questions. He would always be curious within himself and he would question himself about Allah. And one very important question, Allah Azza wa Jal says, Ibrahim asked, إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّي أَرِينِ كَيْفَ تُحْيِيَ الْمَوْتِ قَالَ أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ قَالَ بَلَى وَلَكِنْ يُطْمِنُ قَلْبِي يُطْمِنُ قَلْبِي صدق الله. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he asked Allah, Oh my Lord, how is it that you bring the dead back to life? Allah asked him a question. Do you not believe? He said, Yes, bala, of course I believe. But I want to have sure faith in my heart. And Ibn Abbas, the mufassir of this ummah, he said, commenting what Ibrahim alayhi salam said, not the question, but the reason behind asking the question. It's very important, my dear salam and iman, that before we ask a question, we have a legitimate reason why we want to know. Because if we ask the question, taban, to the right sources, we're not going to ask a dentist about how to fix my brakes. We want to ask the right person the right question. And we want to ask for a legitimate reason. So when we get the answer, then we will transform that questioning into knowledge. So Ibn Abbas, he said that the reason for asking was, وَلَكِنْ يَتَمِنَ قَلْبِي, he said, I'm not asking for any foolish reason. And I believe, but I want to have solace in my heart. I want to be stronger in my faith. Ibn Abbas said, To me, there's no ayah in the Quran that brings more hope than this ayah. This line of questioning of Ibrahim and this ayah in the Quran does not bring any more hope to anyone who wants to know something than this question that he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted Ibrahim's affirmation when he simply said, Bala, yes, I believe, I'm a believer. And this ayat refers to the shak, the doubts, the whispers that the shaitan puts into the hearts of mankind through the thoughts. So when Ibrahim wanted to have yaqeen, surety in his iman, he asked the question, how is the dead risen and comes back to life? And he simply asked Allah. And Allah replied by asking him, do you not believe? And he simply said, yes, I believe. So as to remove the doubt in his heart. So, my dear Salam Iman, if the Khalil of Allah, the friend of Allah, Ibrahim alayhi salam, went through all of those hardships and struggles, can have a doubt in his faith that needed to be removed, what about us? There are many people on a daily basis who have severe shak in their faith to the point they deem themselves as hypocrites, to the point that they feel useless within themselves, to the point they feel suicidal within themselves. So the friend of Allah, Ibrahim, had a query, he had a question, and he didn't hesitate but to ask. We should not self-medicate ourselves. If we have a question, then we should seek the answer from the correct sources. We should not try and play scholar and try and deduce the ruling from the Quran and the Sunnah by ourselves, but we should seek out a legitimate source, a student of knowledge who can direct you to the ulama. So, one of the most important things that we have to understand as believers is that we should try and accompany the people of iman. If we want to be people of iman, then we should be in the habit of accompanying the people who have iman. Because those are the people who will always give us the correct guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has explained to us the process of increasing in our iman. In Surah Sajda, ayat number 24, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجْعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةٍ يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانَ بَيَعَاتِنَا يُقِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we made from amongst the believers leaders guiding others by our command when they had patience and when they were truly believing in our signs with certainty. So the first thing that we need to do as believers is to be patient with our iman. We need to have sabr with our faith. We cannot, when the first strike of problem occurs in our life, we throw away our iman. We need to be patient with our iman. We need to have sabr on the sunnah. As Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal, he had stated in his book, Kitab al-Sunnah, he said, sabr al-adha fiha, that we have to have patience on the harms and afflictions that come with this iman, come with this faith. So, as a result, bi'idhnillah, that we are patient. As a result, that we are patient and we're patiently observing the Quran and we're observing the Sunnah. As a result of our sabr, Allah will elevate some of us to the position of a'imma, leaders, guiding other people. But we cannot be so shaky in our faith that the first sign or the first trouble we have, we start to curse and we want to run away, as if we want to run away and leave ourselves. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. So, for us to be people of iman, then it will require patience, consistency. And bi'idhnillah, as time progresses, Allah will show us signs within ourselves and signs around us that we are people of zuhud. Because we cannot follow any person who does not have the correct sabr, does not have the correct attitude towards the iman. For us to be considered as a'imma, then we have to have patience. And we have to be of those who are patiently observing the sunnah. And those people who are considered as imma, those people are patient themselves. Those people are zahideen. They avoid temptations of this world. May Allah Azza wa Jalla give us the tawfiq to be of those who are patiently preserving our iman. Amen. Bismillah, wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulullah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi man tabi'a huda wa ba'd. Another very important point, my dear brother Salam in Iman, is that regarding those people of Iman, and inshallah, all of us here are people of Iman, and bidhnillah, all of us will now start to make the necessary adjustments in our lives to seek after those deeds of Iman, inshallah. But there's something very important that we have to understand, that those people, the people of Iman, and those people who are striving to be those people of Yaqeen, those who have surety in their faith, they are not ordinary people. Those people who have faith, and then we have those people who are trying to strive and gain surety in their faith, they are not ordinary people. They are not like those people when they're afflicted with some type of a situation in their life. They do not become confused. They do not become worried. They're always calm. They're always calm in their hearts, and their hearts and their body are full of tawakkul ala Allah. They always have this reliance on Allah. They see things. Those people who have iman and those people who are striving to have surety in their iman, they see things with a different lens. They see things with the eye of yaqeen. And there is a hadith which has been recorded in the hadith, the sunnah of Imam Tirmidhi and the sunnah of Abbasid al-Khudri, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اتق فراسة المؤمن فإنه ينظر بنور الله. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you should be weary of that insight of the believer, because they see things with the light of Allah. ثم قرأ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then he recited the ayat, ayat number 75 in Surah Hijr. إن في ذلك الآيات لمتوسمين. In that is a sign. And that is an ibra, a sign for those people who can recognize the sign in things. And that is a sign for those people who can recognize the sign in things. A lot of people who profess to have faith, they're very shaky. At the first strike of fitna, they become shaky to the point that they like they want to run away from themselves, let alone the situation that they're experiencing. So to be a person of Iman is going to take work on our part. We have to struggle against ourselves. We have to look at ourselves, that now we're experiencing some type of a situation. How are we going to react? So let us end off with another important example that Allah Azza wa Jal has given us in the Quran, in Surah, the beginning of Surah Anfal. Anfal were the spoils of war. Allah Azza wa Jal says regarding the believers, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجَلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ إِذَا تُلِيَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. Allah Azza wa Jal, he starts these sets of ayats with pointing to something, that hasr, pointing to something specific within the believers. Verily, the believers, so because we have an outward shape and body and experience within ourselves, outwardly. And inwardly, we have something which moves us, which moves us. Allah Jalla is speaking to something within the believers. Innamal mu'minun, Allah Jalla speaking about the believers, إِذَا ذُكِّرَ اللَّهُ, when they're reminded about Allah, the hearts tremble. وَجَلَ قَلُوبُهُمْ, the hearts start to shake and tremble. إِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, And when their verses of Allah are recited to them, their faith increases. So faith is something which does not just stay still. When the ayats are recited to the believers, their faith, the heart shake. When reminded of Allah, the heart shake and their faith increases. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And they place their trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ صَلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Those believers, they establish the prayer. And what they've been provided with of wealth, monetary wealth, flus, money, they spend it in the path of Allah. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ صَلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. وَاللَّهِكُ هُمَ مُؤْمُنُونَ حَقَّ. They are the true believers, Allah says. Lahum darajat. They have a higher degree. They have lahum a darajat in the rabbihim wa maghfiratin wa rizqan kareem. They have a higher degree with Allah tabarak ta'ala. They have a generous provision with Allah tabarak ta'ala. And they have forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the great Imam, Muhammad Idris Shafi, has been quoted to have said, in Sir Alam Nubula, this noble book talking about the great feats of the awliya, those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Imam Shafi, he said, if you see a man flying in the air or walking on water, don't be amazed with that person until you evaluate their deeds on the scales of the Quran and Sunnah. So we can see people speak in a certain way, as if they're a very strong imani person, or you can see them doing things, but really, we do not know that person until we spend time with that person. Then we'll come to know, is that person a magician, or is that person a real person of the Quran and Sunnah? It has been narrated on Isa ibn Maryam. We'll leave off with this author, that one day a man asked Isa ibn Maryam, how are you able to walk on water? Isa ibn Maryam, he said, it's with my iman. It is with my faith. So the man said, we also have faith in Allah. We also have faith in Allah. And we also believe in Allah. So we believe as you believe. So why can't we do it? Isa said, okay, then come, let us walk. So then Isa ibn Maryam held the man's hand and they started to walk on the water. And the man started to drown, till he drowned. And then Isa ibn Maryam, he took him out from the water. And he said, what happened to you? Kayf hal, what happened to you? What had happened to you? He said, we became frightened when we seen the waves. He said, do you not fear the Lord of the waves? And then when they were on the dry land, Isa ibn Maryam, he took up some sand in his hand, in his right and in his left hand. And then he turned one of them into a pile of gold. It was gold in his hand. And the other one was some pebbles. So he asked the man, which one of these do you like most? He said, I like the gold. I prefer the gold. So Isa ibn Maryam, he said, they are just the same to me. The gold, the dust, they are just the same to me. So inshallah, why I gave this example is, when we, bismillah, as believers, see this world for what it is a thing of possession, commodity. We can earn, we can pray, we can marry, we can do so many things. We can acquire things of this world, but we should not allow our insides to become attached to the things of this world. We have to live a balanced life. And may Allah Azza wa Jal help us with these things that he has given us, of these fruits and blessings of this world, use it as a means to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to realize that we have an opportunity to reap the fruits of our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and open up the heart inside of us so we can realize that we have an opportunity to show Allah our devotion and our love to him. Amin, amin, amin. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Sallu alayhi wa sallimu. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار